Well, this is a little bit better position for Abasov to be in, having Ben Askren in guard, but Ben's gonna slice that left knee through and pass. He's probably gonna go right over here to mount.
There it is.
Or right comes over to cross. Oh, Ben's in on, oh, that's it!
Let's go! Head
and arm triangle!
Oh, head and arm triangle suddenly jumped in on us. And Ben Askren makes his debut with a first round win just inside the 5 minute mark.
Got into side control, but look at Gary Tonin, he adjusted it in. Oh, that's it.
Oh, hold on, wait a minute, let me put some Tonin in it!
Didn't quite have it, third time. Look at these adjustments. This is world-class grappling on display right here. He's like, nope, don't quite have it here. Let me make this minor adjustment. You come in over into me, I'm gonna let you come into me, and then I'm gonna take you on top, mount you, and then I'm gonna finish you.
That was a great back take.
We're looking to see if that left arm is under the throat.
There it is, he sinks it in.
That is under, right under. And this could
the
be
game
it. He's
it's over.
It's over.
And still.
Here's how it finished. He got up on his back. The extent of the arm around the throat at that point was hard for us to see. Was it under the chin there, or was it cranking the chin inwards? There, it was quite conclusive, wasn't it? Right around the throat.
Certainly among the females, but Angela Lee is looking to take her place pretty quickly. Oh, and there's the elbow. Sure, she's got to give. There's no tap yet.
Is doing a very good job. She's defending right there, but then she sinks it right into the armpit and just completely extends it. Very beautiful.
Beautifully, Marat gets beautifully takes his Nguyen's back, and he looks to have a deep choke in here. And this is one. This is 30 less than.
Could be over very quickly,
and it is a deep rear naked choke 40 seconds into the first round. Shocking that Nguyen actually initiates the takedown, but Marat just slips around, takes his back. See how he traps that left arm there with his leg, locks in the body triangle, and then secures the rear naked choke right underneath Nguyen's chin. And he had just moments before the lights went out, or he taps or naps.
But Bernario's changing up the game plan and attempting for the takedown.
It looks like is the cost.
It might be. He might have this deep, Steve.
He's tapped. Oh! It's over. Etting has finished it in under a minute.
You can see Miss Slide. It's an arm-in guillotine. He's got that throat tightly wrapped, and he just wraps his legs around, flips it into mount, and there's nothing Bernario can do to relieve the pressure except to tap. Here it is again from a different angle. We see Bernario try to get in, but he's got just that deep, deep guillotine. You see the color drain from his face.
You really could, couldn't you? He went a deep purple.
As Ting just sinks in that guillotine for the first round finish.
If she can secure the other foot on the other side of the leg, she's gonna have a much more dominant position and probably work from the chokes.
Can't get all the way around just now.
Now she's kind of rolling her over here.
Natalie's cut.
And this, she could be setting up the twister here, Steve.
Wow, what a finish.
You can see here, Angela throw, gets tossed to the ground by Natalie. Natalie right there should have stood back up and disengaged and let Angela come back up. A beautiful sweep to Angela back on top where she delivers some ground and pound. And you can see here, she secures the arm. I don't think Natalie knew what she was doing. And then she just starts cranking on the neck right there.
And no wonder he turns around, but in doing so, he presents his back to Gafarov again, looking for six rear naked chokes in a row. 28 seconds left.
He's not quite under the chin, Steve. He's pretty close. It's right on the mouth there. I think Damba's gonna be able to hold on here for the next 15 seconds or so, but Gafarov is squeezing with every ounce that he has.
Oh, I think it's gone under the chin, and it's over. It's a first round finish for the champion. There it is, it was on the chin. It was a chin crank, but there it was when it slipped underneath, and from there it was just a matter of moments, and those moments passed very quickly indeed.
It's a dangerous game he's playing, Steve.
Oh, the leg lock there. Oh, wow. You know, they change positions so frequently in that final minute. One man had the advantage and then the other, and the slickness that Alex Silva managed to produce there in order to get that leg lock. Oh, that was a highlight reel move.
Fernandez yanking his right arm free.
See, but with that trap, you know, by trapping his arm, he enabled Bibiano to slide that knee now across his belly, which gives him a better position. And now,
looking for the arm bar now is Fernandez.
That's a nasty Kimura he's giving.
Kimura, there's the tap. Went for the straight arm bar, transitions into the Kimura, and finishes.
And he remains firmly on top of ONE Championship's bantamweight division.
It is relentless, isn't it? Mahmoud is not giving. He's not given a chance. Is that Kimura he's looking for?
Now he's just locking that arm into position like that. He's possibly setting it up as he slides his left arm underneath.
I think he's tapped, looking. He's tapped.
Oh, that's a nice shoulder submission right there.
Rich, just looking at these replays, Christian Lee not afraid to do the unorthodox, is he?
You can see the experience in the grappling, because that's a deep arm bar right there. You've got to keep both hands either inside the legs or the outside of the legs. And when you have just one arm inside, you're basically giving your opponent an arm bar or a triangle. And right now, she's caught in a deep triangle, Steve.
She's really all ends up, isn't she? Not much she can do here. And she's tapped out. There it is. The crowd's noise rings in his ears. Again, Muhammad Ali goes for the single leg.
Oh, there's a possible guillotine. It's deep.
It's tapped out. It's over.
You can see him get the single leg, and Ong Long Seng just kind of sneaks in that guillotine, locks the hand around. You can see Muhammad Ali trying to push away, but then the choke was just too much, and he couldn't get out.
A submission acquired on the counter. And it was so tight that it really didn't take Muhammad Ali very long to figure out that he'd had enough of that one.
And his movement, he's capable of so many different things. I mean, there's a possible choke here. It's like a bomb fluke choke. It's kind of like, it's possible.
He's tapped out. Boku's tapped.
Tap, I don't think the referee's
seen it.
I think it's punches. I don't think he's tapping.
I'm not sure.
Look
like a tap.
Does he tap
it? Yeah, I think Boku tapped it. And that's why he's out.
I don't know, man. He was punching, but at that point he went out. I don't think he was tapping. I think he was trying to fight it off. And now Pasternak's giving him his back. I only can assume that that hand is gonna come under it. Here's the arm triangle. He's sliding over. It's a matter of time, Steve.
Yuji Shimada's watching very carefully. I'm not sure that he's got consciousness. It's out and it's over. It all happened in a way that was quite different from his last ONE Championship contest. He used his jiu-jitsu and he drew the submission so smoothly that Pasternak just drifted out of consciousness and into sleep. The most complete way for a BJJ specialist to end a contest. There you can see the arm is dull.
Immediately gets into the clinch, gets the hand under the neck.
Looking for the power guillotine. Now the body lock to counter from Jeddah Boussabai. A lot of squeeze on that. There's the tap.
Seconds, I think it was like, what, 20 seconds? You can see once he got the guillotine, he started cranking the second arm over his shoulder to apply that additional pressure. Deep, deep.
Olivier Cost, he knew it was tight, stepping in, the recognition on the submission.
Very good wrestling there.
Beautiful takedown. No, he's got the
rear naked. Oh my goodness,
rear
naked choke.
He's under the chin.
That is deep, that is so deep.
No!
Oh my goodness. How things change so quickly. And it's just, you know, being able to get that ground control. You know, he's here, he's got that hook in on one side, and he got it really, really deep. He put it on top of the shoulder, and then he dug the arm in. He doesn't even have two hooks, and now he's got the body lock, the body triangle. That was deep, and Joshua Pasquale's face, it was a look of sadness there, as he knew he'd lost every hope of winning that.
Hot knife through butter. He just slid through that guard of Jordan Lucas, and now he's attempting. Oh, beautiful jump over pass. Oh, he's got a choke in.
My, that is wow, that was fantastic. He put so much pressure on there. He had so much leverage.
Take a look at this, Peter. Talk us through it.
He hits the cage, rolls off the cage, down on that choke. It is so tight, and he tries to get his hips as far back as possible to put the pressure on. He knew it was in. It was just a case of how long he had to hold on. And Jordan Lucas reluctantly taps. Oh, he really didn't want to tap there.
Good ground control shown by Kingad here. He's transitioning into an arm
bar. Oh, and it looks good at these taps straight away. Beautiful. So Kingad wasn't having any of that. Just 21 years old, remember, and he's beaten in Eugene Toquero, a man who is well known in this cage, and that was an instant submission, Mitch.
Oh, that was beautifully done.
Jenny Huang's got a left foot on Asensio's hip. She'll try and push that away, but
looks like she's setting up maybe a go-go plata here. Oh, does she tap? Beautiful submission there. I don't know if you guys saw that at home. This angle, the shin is under the throat of Asensio. She's able to pull down on the back of the neck. Credit to Rich Franklin for catching that. But that was a go-go plata submission. Nicolini's easy. Here comes that arm.
Oh, that arm's in trouble now.
Here's the arm. She's better. She's going to tap, or she's going to take it home.
She's tapping, and it was over quickly. And the winner is Michelle Nicolini.
Look at that. She captures the forearm right under the armpit, locks into position. There's no way that can go. And Marina, the only way Irina can save that arm is to tap her way out.
Yeah, sensible move to get tapping there. She's gone on record, Mitch. Michelle Nicolini as saying she wants Ann Osmond next.
Look at this, just steps over, shin there. Beautiful armbar.
Well, it looked like it was an absolute necessity to tap, let's put it that way.
Marias closes the figure four around the body. That's gonna affect the breathing. Here comes Marias. Kingad in trouble, in trouble, in trouble. Marias taps him out.
Look at this. Immediately, the hand was under the neck. Once if he couldn't defend the left arm that was under the neck, the only thing that was saving him was Marias had the right hand underneath the armpit of Danny Kingad.
As Suzuki is free, will Silver go back to the left arm?
You almost saw a helicopter armbar now.
Excellence in this execution.
Look at this control, trapped it up, figure fours the arm, beautifully done. I want to go back, I want to see how he got to that position.
Did you see the way he was almost screaming in pain? What an armbar from Silva. Enrique takes her time.
She's spinning the wrong way, she's right in the corner. There, she's got a turn.
Second round. She goes for the armbar here. Once the hands come loose on Rome Trinidad, she gets out of it. And then Rika gets her down, takes the back, puts the hooks in. And watch this. Hooks are in. Figure four body lock. The beginning of the end. look at the determination here from Priscilla Hertati Lumbangol and Lumbaga. Surviving. No, she's gone now.
Is that a straight arm lock?
Priscilla Hertati Lumbangol taps out. Have a look at it again here. Walk us through this, Mitch.
Lumbangol was able to secure the takedown. That was the first takedown. That wasn't where she finished the job. But there she can see her trying to get to the back. The ground game of Lumbangol has definitely improved by leaps and bounds. Here's some of those knees. Not a big knee, but scored a little bit of points. Then we saw that she was able to get the headlock. And from the headlock position, here's the armbar coming up.
Boom shakalaka! Boom shakalaka! Tiny takes him down! Far on now!
This could be it.
It's good night, Irene!
Gets the Americana. Trying for a straight armbar, says, nope, I want the Americana, the key lock. And almost twisted the raw completely off.
One of the most aggressive incarnations we've ever seen of Aguilar Tani.
As Christian Lee's going for the neck. Oh, is that same choke? Is that same side?
Oh, it's good night, Irene!
Check this out. He traps the arm, jumps on top, sits down onto it, falls down. Beautifully done.
McLaren hopes for a takedown.
Ooh,
gets a takedown. Subaru on his back. McLaren's got him melted again.
Falls
now passes to side control. Here's the choke.
Arm triangle.
Here's
deep.
The choke. Hold on. Wait a minute. Let me put some lightning in it. Here's what went down in this incredible finish.
Look at that double leg. Got the knee tap. Fell into the top position. Got the mount. Right into the arm triangle, and that's how big, how strong of a squeeze that McLaren's got.
Easy pass from Broginho. Now he's got an arm triangle on that one side, and to escape it, Alvarez might give up his back, and oh, he's gonna take the arm triangle.
Turning. This one could be over. It's good night, Irene! Rocked early on by the left hands of Roman Alvarez. He recomposed himself in a hurry. Turn counterclockwise here.
Watch out your fingers.
Chambers the right, couldn't get it off. What's he looking for here, Mitch?
Oh, Catalan's going after a leg again. Looks like he's possibly got a heel hook.
Yep. And he has indeed. Beautiful submission in the second round for Robin Catalan, and he is elated.
Check this out, right there. He lays the leg. Locked his right leg over the hip right there. He's nice and high, has the heel caught in the lock, and then just slowly started to extend the hips. Letting those hands go. He's doing so well in the stand-up. Why is he trying to clinch? Maybe this is why. Maybe because he sees something in the ground and pound.
Big right hand, missed the target. Sexton takes the back now, Shimoishi.
Oh,
look at this! Look at this! Shimoishi in trouble! He's all tied up like a pretzel! And it's good! Night! Freaking Irene! That was amazing!
Shimoishi was trying to tangle. He steps over. He was kind of looking for that the entire time. Look at that. Americana. Reverse triangle. Oh, no place to go. What a world of hurt.
That's two submissions for the price of one.
Look at this finish. Has a beautiful reverse triangle, and then look at that, cranks on the key lock.
You try to get underneath the chin. It's close. Might be a little bit too high. He needs to settle down a little bit lower.
Mitsutsu is undefeated, 9-0. He may be staring down the barrel of his first ever loss.
Oh, look what Josh Pasha.
He is! Here it is, Mitch.
Take a look at this. Oh, it's not doing, the angle is not doing it justice. Look at this, how he has the arm, and then he cranks it completely back.
Oh, pay it, Mitch, rear naked chicken wing.
Maybe we could call
it. You've dumped it.
Maybe we could call it a reverse Kimura. I don't know what that was. What if Henzo finishes with the passion lock?
How about this? How about
this? Oh, there's the rear naked choke. It's in.
How about this? Go on, man. Go on, man. That's good. Nice, Irene. Henzo Gracie's back. And look at this. Puts the hooks in, sinks the rear naked choke, and Kondo forced to tap out before he goes to sleep.
Everything's got a hold of that head, but he's got to let go of that head and start pushing away. Shinya Aoki, he's actually helping Aoki. You don't want to get, you want to create space when you're defending, you know? And that, and by holding the head like this, he's keeping Aoki tight to him. And there's also a choke right here. Here comes the arm triangle.
Is it going to be an early finish? Is Evting in trouble? He's going to sleep! He's going to sleep! He's going to sleep! That's three in a row! They're all first-round finishers! Shinya Aoki, the number one contender for the lightweight championship!
Wow, Shinya Aoki got the choke. He did exactly what I said he was going to do. Look at Potar trying to keep nice and tight. He's trying to get back into half guard. Ah, oh, look at that. Suba's going after the neck now.
Oh, yeah. Puta tapped. It's good night, Irene.
He steps over the head, slides the neck right under the arm, gets both hands clasped. This is what Keanu Suba does so brilliantly. Look at that guillotine. It's so tight. Look at, let's take another look at it. It was that good. He steps over the head, clasps the hands, puts that knee right in the middle of his solar plexus and just starts cranking. He's got to be careful as Imanari starts to triangle his legs. He's trying to lock that into position. Radim's got to be very careful right here.
Not where Rahman wanted to be in the opening seconds of this mixed martial arts contest. Imanari early omoplata shoulder lock on the Singaporean, gets out of it now. But look at this here, takes the arm. Oh. Can he finish him in the first round, Imanari?
Look at this beautiful transition here. Radim tried to go, he tried to go the wrong way, but look how deep that armbar is. Look at both hands here, clasping the hand. Radim is deep inside that armbar. You can see Radim is defending here. Oh, there's tap. A tap. There's a tap right there on Imanari's leg. There you go, Shea Chow is able to slide out, back up into the clinch. Bruno Pucci jumps into a guillotine.
Can he find the choke finish here? Bruno Pucci in the very first round.
Oh, looks like Shea Chow's gonna pop his head out. Looks like he's got a little bit of space. Oh, but it might be across the neck, that's it.
Oh, he's asleep, he's asleep.
Let's take a look at that again, look at that. He just comes over the top with the left hand, goes pan to hand, has the guillotine. You can see all that space here then. He readjusts his feet, gets nice and tight. If you're inside Bruno Pucci's guard, that is the worst place in the world to be, because if you don't tap, you're gonna take a nap. Oh, and he gives up his back as he starts to air. Beautiful.
Have a look at this from Wada. Is he gonna choke him out? Yes, he is. My word, what a win for Wada.
Look at this, Tokero immediately gives up his back like that. Wada takes it, has that leg butt grapevine right there. He sinks both hooks and doesn't even get that second hook and chooses to leave it right there. But just that squeeze is so tight from Wada, capturing a beautiful choke finish for Tatsumitsu Wada. She's trying to take her right leg and hook the leg of Miura, but she's having a hard time doing it. Now she's trying to go belly down. Yuta's trying to scarf hold. Yep, that's what that is right there. Uh-oh.
And she's done it again. How about that?
Yeah, that was pretty tight. Look at this takedown. She gets the front headlock, and then Balin goes over the top of the hip. Beautiful takedown. Her top game is something special with that judo. Uh-huh. Welcome to the strawweight division.
Another Imanari roll, he's got it now. This could be danger for the pretty boy. This is Imanari land, this is Imanariville.
But look at that, he was able to adjust and now he's inside. Kwon Hill's gotta put that
That's it, old school Imanari, old school Imanari, old school Imanari, he's done it again. He's making a comeback, Mitch. He is making a comeback.
Wow, that was lightning fast. He dove on the leg three times. And look at that. Look how he wraps up the legs.
Johnson hunting for a finish as we approach the halfway mark of this contest. As Mitch said earlier, it's been a long, long time since Demetrious Johnson has been in a three-rounder. Now can he take that arm home? No, not yet. Here's some knees to the collarbone. Demetrious trying to choke it. Can he get it? Can he get it? It's good night, Irene! That's Mighty Mouse, Demetrious Johnson.
Look at this, has the guillotine. Yuya Wakamatsu did everything he could to try to avoid that, but look how tight that is. Look at the guillotine. You can see Yuya Wakamatsu tries to turn out of it. He tries to angle out, but look at that. That's how tight that is. Demetrious, Mighty Mouse Johnson, just moves forward in the one flyweight World Grand Prix.
Have a look at the squeeze from Mighty Mouse. Locks out moisture, seals in freshness. Good night, Irene.
Looking for an armbar.
Armbar from Vivi May Yamaguchi. Is she going to tap her out in the third and final round? Yes, she does. It's a win for Yamaguchi. It's a win for Japan.
Look at this. Ducks under the punches coming from Lachkova. Chases down the double leg. And then she was able to slide through the guard. There she is landing a big knee to soften Lachkova up. Inside control, she passed into mount. You can see Lachkova extending the arms, gift wrapping the arm bar. Mei Yamaguchi takes it home like Christmas and gets the finish. Look at this adjustment. There's the thumb, watch the thumb. The thumb has to stay up. There's no place for Lachkova to go.
If it goes to ground, both men are very well equipped, but of course, toning down is an utter genius. And we're down there at the moment. This is trouble for Nakahara. It doesn't last long. He's 5-0. And Mitch again, it was brilliant. And Mitch, this is why Gary Tonin said to everyone, come at me now, because in a year's time, I will be truly unstoppable.
Yeah, look at the way he wraps up this leg. He gets the he triangles the leg. And then, but watch his right leg. Watch what he does with his right leg. He puts it on the shoulder of Nakahara, so Nakahara is not able to sit up and disengage with the hands. Look at that. He actually prevented him from sitting up and hand fighting with his own foot. That is some high-level jiu-jitsu.
Misha, a lot of people expected Tonin to win, but nobody thought he'd do it that quickly. Still looking to pass, now does, cuts the hip in nicely, does Harada, some ground and pound, far arm control from Harada. This is her specialty, this is what she does so well. Will she take that arm home to Japan? It's a good Harada. 1:14, and it's indeed going back to Japan. She's done it.
Look at this key lock, she steps over the head right there and just starts cranking on that arm. There's no place for Sabanal to go, and you can see she was forced to tap her way back to the Philippines.
Oh, beautiful. Oh, have a look at it. He's on top now. Alvarez on top, and he turns the tide, and now it goes silent.
And you got to know what's going on with that leg, though. You got to question it. How bad was his leg hurt with that thunderous leg kick landed by Folayong? Now Eddie's trying to work his way into mount. Is that topside jiu-jitsu we were talking about, Michael? And they
Folayong
flatten him
gets
out.
His back. He's flattened out. This is not good from Folayong. Alvarez will take his time. He'll try and work the choke.
Oh, look at him prying up that chin.
This could be the beginning of the end. That's good night, Irene!
Look at this. Pulls up the chin. Look at him. Prying the neck up. Slides his right hand right underneath the chin. Sinks in the rear naked choke. And then Folayong is forced out of the lightweight World Grand Prix. There's the tap right there.
Elbow, another one. Between the eyes of Ashiroka. Now she gives up her back. Stamp Fairchek softens her up. Roka with no place to go. Stamp's gonna try and choke her out. Is it the beginning of the end? Roka trying to defend.
Stan Vertex attached to her back. And a long time to go here. Plenty of time for Stan. Oh, yes! Oh, yes! Oh, yes! Have a look at this again. Has the back of Ashiroka softens her up. Roka, no place to go. And this is the beginning of the end for the Indian. Stamp took her time, softened her up just enough, sunk the choke, and Roka had no option but to tap out.
The right hand still working hard from Hirata, looking to punish that face of the Thai woman.
Wow.
Oh, sweet move.
Nice. She's going to the Kimura here.
Looking very difficult.
Headlock Kimura.
The headlock's
That's
all
tight.
Tied in. The arms under pressure. The tap comes. And Hirata takes it late in the second round. She was threatening to do so since the early moments of this contest. She's bringing the crowd into it now. Nullify the head, you control the body, and that allowed her to work on the arm. And once this movement had taken place and the arm was released, it was never going to be long before Rika Ishige would tap the canvas, signaling to the referee that she'd had enough. And Hirata, out of your picture, is absolutely delighted, beckoning to the crowd to give them all of their love.
Aoki knows how to finish opponents, hasn't gone to a decision since his win over Koji Ando in May 2015 in Singapore. And this is Aoki land.
Oh, beautifully done. Look how he snuck that arm in there looking for that choke. Now he's got a baseball bat choke. Now he switches into a dart.
Oh, this could be the beginning of the end for Honorio Benario. The Rocket a whole lot above it now. Aoki twist, Aoki turn, it's good night, Irene! Aoki does it again! The man is a genius! Have a look at this. It was the beginning of the end. Once Aoki's got you in this position, there's nowhere to go. You tap, or you go to Nana land. Aoki puts the squeeze on. Benario, it's either go to sleep or go to tap. He chose to tap.
Yeah, it looks like he's trying to attempt a Kimura lock there on the hands as he tried to roll through. Good job by Piak to hold that body lock nice and tight and maintain positioning. You can see that Lito Adiwan, I don't know if you can see, but he's got a Kimura grip on that arm right there, and he's going to try to use it to sweep and reposition.
Adiwan has not lost a match since 2014. A 90% finishing rate, you can see why, including a massive amount of first round finishers. He's had 5 in his last 6 bouts have been first round finishers. He's looking for another one here.
He's still going for it.
He's done it, he's done it, he's done it. It's good night, Irene. First round wins in 11 career victories now for the Thunder Kid.
Look at that, takes it up over the head, beautifully done. I think he learned that from Joshua Pashiao for the passion lock, almost the same. Another beautiful submission win from Team Lakai. Look at this, he steps over the head, locks it into position, starts cranking on the arm, locks up that body lock.
Oh, smack dang on the canvas, beautifully down from Yuri Olympicus, takes the back, can he reunite, can Choi Gaffer up? This would be insane, this would be crazy. This would be awesome!
Gafarov's not even trying to defend!
Is it gonna tap?
Is that a tap?
It's over! It's over! It's over!
Look at this beautiful throw. Might have threw up on his head because he didn't even defend. Look at this squeeze by Lapicus. What a statement in the lightweight division.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.